One.
Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to each and every one of you watching. To the viewers and the listeners, I hope you're well and good. Today I am here with my panel members, my guests, as we're going to be talking, we're going to be having a little girl talk, talking about tips and advice on dating. So I'm Nerato and I'll be your host for today. So sit back, get something to drink, a little popcorn, and get comfortable. So I'm going to start by introducing my panel members over here. I'll start from this side. We have Wetu Mavuso. We have Males Lego. We have Lile Jamini. And we have Manuendo Kacha. Since you've already heard the topic and title of our discussion, which is around the topic dating, the first question you may have in mind is, what is dating? Well, two, could you please answer my question for us?
Okay. Hello to the viewers. Thank you so much for having me here. It's such an honor to be here in the podcast. So dating is basically a modern trend where two individuals meet up together and try to connect with each other to see if maybe they could develop some sort of bond or relationship that could possibly last their entire lifetime together. So that pretty much is dating. Yeah.
Do you guys have anything to add?
Fine.
Okay. Question two is for you, Magus Wiggle. What is the most important thing, to do when you want to explore dating?
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Thank you so much for watching. The most important thing as a Christian is to have a relationship with God. Mm-hmm. Remember, everything starts with God and it continues with Him and it ends with Him. So you must first get yourself on the right platform of right relationship with God and make sure that you give God your plans so that you start together with God, because without God, you will definitely not get far from what you're doing, because on your own, you can do nothing. But with Him, all is impossible. All is possible.
Very true. Do you guys have anything to add? The third question is for you. At what period or stage should a girl start dating?
Well, welcome everyone. Thank you, Lerato, for the question. A girl should start dating when she's an adult, finished school, and has achieved all the goals she has in life and is ready for a relationship.
Yes, we have anything to add?
I would just add that if you start with dating, because that's where you get to know each other, and then you can't have a relationship with a person that you don't know. So it is important to date and do the right things that are done at dating. Don't confuse a relationship with dating, because dating, there's no commitment. But once you get into a relationship, there's now some kind of like commitment. And the most important commitment is after a relationship, you get into marriage, where it's a commitment for a lifetime.
The following question is also for you, Magus Bego. How many partners should a girl date or be with at a time?
Obviously, it is one. Because more than one, it's a crowd. And it is difficult to deal with a crowd than to deal with one person. It has to be one person, because once it becomes more than one, you will start comparing. And also, once you start comparing, your standards that you had set for yourself will start to drop, because you will now start preferring the other one above the other one. It should just be one person, because you want to get to know the person. They say more than one is a crowd, and a crowd has some kind of like impact that makes you not to stick to your standards that you've put for yourself. So it has to be one for it to make a positive impact.
No, I don't. deal with heartbreaks during dating?
Thank you, Lerato. Hi, viewers. Yo, break up with whom?
For everyone, with whom you break up. For me, I would say, just cry. Allow yourself to be. Because one way you would express my feelings are called, if with everything happening. But you should be grateful with the heartbreak. I guess they go talked about with the dating gives birth to the relationship, then from relationship to marriage. So discovered when this person is like this. What am I going to do? You don't have options. That's it. My energy break up. More would say, at least you show me this person Ugandjena, and I should accept. That's all I can say.
If I may come in, it is very important that you acknowledge the hurt and the unfortunate space that you find yourself in once there's a heartbreak. Because at that point you'll be able to go back to the drawing board and look at yourself of what you've contributed towards the heartbreak. Instead of just jumping to conclusion to say there's a heartbreak because of the other person. Remember, it takes two to tango. And also you must know that maybe the other person does come to church every Sabbath, but the person doesn't have a relationship with God. So you all started the whole thing on a presumption that you're on the same level. But if there's something you reach a heartbreak, it makes you to now go back to the drawing board to say, my God, is it you that showed me this? And then accept that God maybe is preventing you from getting to the point where you could have seen, where you could have discovered at the point of no return. Because remember, dating, you want to get to know the person. It doesn't mean that when you want to get to know the person, you will only see good things. Actually, for any friendship, you must be able to know that my friend gets angry. How does my friend deal with being angry? How does my friend deal with being happy? So you must be able to go back to the drawing board and thank God and ask God to deal with your heartbreak before you can start thinking of moving forward, because there's this thing called a rebound. A rebound, most of the time, it has very negative results, because you get to a point, you are at a point where you want to prove to the other person that you messed up, I didn't mess up, I'm a better person, you're not a better person. Once you do that, you're going to get an even worse heartbreaks now, not even a heartbreak one, because you will have moved from the platform where you have a partner that is God, who's going to clear the way and show you where there's mist, there's a storm coming, God is surely to show you. So you really need to acknowledge and give yourself space and deal with your own emotions before you can start off taking another step forward. Thank you.
Just to maybe end on what my Bego said. Okay. Ngiyaphakaza ukuthi maye sibeke ukukhuluma ngokuthi as girls asiphume kulomqondo weku always playing the victim card. I am a victim. This happened. I am a victim. Like asiphume lapho. She talked about going back to the drawing board. Vele. I think that's okay. Vumelana nawe maye sibeke.
Yeah, to also add, sometimes it's very hard to actually own up our actions, our words, and how we like just genuinely feel. as girls, and then like maybe at times the emotional intelligence will always like, nah, it cannot be my fault. But then, you know, you just have to sit down. You have to sit down. You have to sit down with God and be like, God, okay, this happened. The heartbreak happened. So then this and this and this, this is what I contributed to my own heartbreak. So yeah, it's very, very important to just like reflect on your own actions.
Remember this, we said dating gives birth to a relationship, to put it loosely. And relationships give birth to a lifetime commitment. Mm. When you are able to say, when things don't go your way, to sit down and think, it means even in the lifetime commitment, when you get there, you'll be able to rationalize things, not go by emotions. Mm.
That's very true. The following question is, what should a girl child do when no one inside the church is showing interest, yet those outside the church are showing interest? Mm. I guess we would like to answer
that.
Yeah.
that's a very wide one. Really. But my attempt would be, first of all, I'm an adult. So what I'm saying it even to myself. You know, the pool of the Adventist church as an international church is wider than the church where you fellowship in, is wider than the district that you belong to. It's wider than the country that you know, but it is international. So make it your practice that when there's a meeting of young people or when there are church meetings outside your church, move from the comfort of your church.
Yeah.
By that way, you're opening a pool, your own pool, you're making it even wider, so that you can get many, many types of fishes. Joking on love affairs.
Mm.
And you're not supposed to joke on love affairs, because love affairs is a serious thing. Mm. Loving, we saw it from God, we got it from God, and God never joked about loving us. Mm. He meant it. To an extent that he gave his only begotten son. Mm-hmm. So let's understand that dating and a relationship are two different things. Don't put yourself in a corner like you have a schedule that between this time and this time, I should find a person who's interested in me. Really, how about your standards?
Mm-hmm.
How about your standards? Because you should know first what you want, who you are, and what is good for you.
Yeah.
Not that you want to get to date because other people are dating.
Mm.
This is not a game.
Mm.
And this is an institution that God put at the beginning, like the Sabbath.
Yeah.
So marriage is a serious thing. Don't play on love issues.
Mm.
First start being friends.
Mm.
Because a friend, you can tell everything.
Yeah.
Dating is like being a friend. So be a friend. Don't start jumping and getting into other things, because you will get hurt. It hurts. It hurts. Some of us are talking through experience. Take time to know him. Because we're going to be talking about a gay child. There's a song by Percy Slade.
Yeah.
It says, take time to know him. But I'm saying to you, take time to know him. Give yourself enough time to date before you jump into a relationship, because dating has no commitment. And also, don't hide it. Make it open in the church. But I wish the church would go back to availing opportunities where the youth could be able to meet.
Yeah.
As a district, as a country, and go to international places outside the country of Swaziland. So that's what should be. When there's a camp meeting, mine would be to suggest to those in charge in the conference to say, the Sabbath after sunset, there must be a bonfire. So that the young people will be able to mix and mingle. You know, they can sleep at 2 o'clock in the morning, because the following day, the service that we should be having, in my opinion, should be the closing service at 10:30 so that you can sleep, wake up, clean, so that you have a service near Hamba, because you will have been there for a week. You've made some contacts, you've seen each other. So when you are playing now, having games, sitting, you are able to connect and know each other. But take time to know him.
So what if there's this gentleman? He's not from the Adventist Church. He's not from the Adventist Church. But then me and him, we have known each other. I know him and he knows me. And then
he's
like,
friend.
Yeah, he's my friend. We're on other basis, right? Uh-huh. And then I see that, okay, the problem that me and you could potentially have in the future is our churches, that they let me go to church to worship God. So then the gentleman, the guy says that, I know, I'm going to follow you wherever you go. So then, like, what is wrong with that? Because I'm taking him from, like, the Sunday worship, right, into the Sabbath,
you know,
church. So then, like, what is wrong with that? Or
once you ask a question to say, what is wrong with that?
Yeah.
It means there is a gap, there is a percentage that you believe that there's something wrong with this thing. Mm-hmm. Because if there's nothing wrong, you will not ask that question. Mm-hmm. And also, it's not about worshiping on a specific day. Mm-hmm. It's about, when I started talking, I said, are you starting having God as your partner? Are you starting, do you want to start dating with a person springing from the same level, which is you guys, you must be all children of God. Because God says, if you love me, keep my commandments. If you love someone, if you love God to that extent, like you love this boyfriend of yours that is not in the church, there is something wrong, because it means you love the boyfriend more than God. Because you are now compromising to say, if you will go with me to church, instead of saying that if we could be able to help each other so that our relationship with God becomes strong. Because once your relationship with God is strong, both of you will be able to follow what the Bible says and what God says. Mm-hmm. You are going to do it. So it starts with God, like I said, and it ends with God. God first, and everything and everyone else, they come after God.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The last question is for you, dealing with a crush, how can a girl approach a guy she has a crush on, in your opinion?
In my opinion,
And don't go to a person, if you see that maybe you are now into this thing, you've missed this crush of yours to an extent that it makes you not to think properly, you better get someone that you are going to get close to the guy through. Don't go, because you are going to sell yourself out. Your actions and everything will sell you out and make yourself vulnerable to an extent that this guy can take advantage of you, even though he was not thinking of that. But because when it's like you're encouraging him to say, hey, when I slim afuga, we are born, you will get hurt. Yes, but there's nothing wrong with the girl having a crush on a boy. It's something natural, so don't feel bad. And also don't feel like when you befriend the opposite sex, like boys, you are construed as a loose person. It's not, it's only those people that don't understand that some girls, they prefer a friendship with boys. They are more close to boys, maybe because of your growing background, you had so many brothers, so you're cool with interacting, as you guys say. So girls, they bore you because they talk about, in your expectation, useless things. They talk about clothes, whatever, whatever. That's when you want jokes, you want jokes, and you feel you're good with boys. And also make sure that you identify people in church that you see that they will be able to assist you and help you. Don't do it on your own, because even in marriage, we've not survived because we're doing it on our own.
Any closing
remarks? Okay, I don't know whether to put it as a question or statement. So let's say that I'm dating this guy and then like we end up getting married without like having to form that friendship relationship type of relationship. So then could there be problems maybe in the marriage, like as the years continue progressing, could there be problems? But when the guy is just like himself, he seems like he's like genuine, you know, everything that he does is out of love. So then could there be problem by skipping the friendship part, just like going straight into marriage, knowing fully that this person, okay, not 100%, 100%, but you guys get that, which in your quick times, you just know it, and he shows it, the actions show it, not so then could there be a problem skipping the friendship part, or it's not really needed?
The part of my friendship, you won't know the other side of him. So you find that the top thing inside the marriage. So important the relationship before marriage.
But that's the thing, a person is always evolving.
Yeah.
A person is always evolving. So then, since marriage is a journey, what can it not be like we are still discovering each other like every single day? He's still learning me, like the deep parts of me, and same goes for him. I'm still learning about him. So, you know, we learn each other, we grow with each other. Isn't like marriage not supposed to be like that? Like we just find the friendship along the way, you know. I learn how to deal with his anger. I learn like new word development. Because we don't have an option. It's like growing together, you know, and like experiencing new things together. Like he's just busy evolving, you know, because I'm gonna move as a family. Challenge for like forever. As a 30 or 20, but you're bigger, he matures up, gets more wisdom, gets more enlightenment. So,
maturity is a relevant term. Would you be able to gauge that this person has matured from here to there?
I mean, if we are.
I'm saying. Once you are transparent with that person, it means you're friends.
But then you can discover that in the marriage.
Marriage, it's not a place, there's no triad in marriage. Remember, in marriage, you are given a certificate first. It's the only university that you get a certificate. By just saying, I'm enrolling in this institution, they say, you're enrolling, yes, they give you a certificate. And then your whole life, you have to prove yourself worthy of the certificate. So if you started, you had not made up your mind to say, I want to follow this profession, you will not be able to finish what you started. So you really need to get to know the person, because once a person is your friend, you know the person's family, you know the person's friends, you know there are some things that you will know, because you will even go and visit this person's home. At least know some people with that person. Because even in the Bible says, can two people walk together before they agree? They definitely can't. So there is some standards that you have to have, you know. Because remember, the standards are not only yours. You've made these standards with God.
So you have to, from constantly consulting uNkulunkulu ukuthi because the standard this angisasiboni singiso yini kuhamba njani, you touch base with your partner lo uNkulunkulu. You're not just going there by your feelings, because my feelings can be deceiving. And when a person wants you, they will do and say what will make you, what will tickle you. Lolo kuthanda mabakubona ukuthi when I say this, we are smiled away. The person will continue saying that. They will tell you music to your ears, but not the truth. Because remember, you will get married to an African man. I don't know Europeans. But an African man.
But an African man. I'm being truthful.
The African man, when you get married to an African man, you're not getting married to this man or to this woman. You're getting married to the family. You know,
yes.
To the family. So don't think that your challenges will come from between the two of you. It will not come from between the two of you. So you really need to take time to know the person and know where the person comes from. Because so you can meet a person here in church, that the person comes from a Sangoma's place. The mother is a Sangoma. When you are saying the person ticks all the boxes, it's not all about you. It's about who you belong to yourself.
Mm.
You belong to God. So the person must tick your boxes and God's boxes. So that God is going to be your foundation.
Mm.
Don't go, it's not about you. Marriage, remember I said, is an institution that was founded and initiated by God. The Sabbath is an institution, the same, that was sanctified by God. Are you able to keep the Sabbath on your own without God? Who does marriage belong to? Does it belong to you or it belongs to God? In that marriage, remember, it's still a field for you to be an ambassador for God. It's not about you. Without God, things they don't always go smooth, but with God, even if they don't go smooth, you still have a bounce back person that you trust and will never leave you nor forsake you and is truthful.
I guess well, Ukulumene, I would say I should get to know this friend of mine. Because there's also going to be temptation.
No, listen. When you are dating, there is no commitment, remember.
There's no commitment.
There is no commitment. So you are not committed to this person. Let's go there and disobey your parents. Remember, you're still under your parents' parents' home. You still belong to your parents. And the Bible says what? Children? You never stop being a child to your parents. Even when you are married, even when you are grown up, you still have to obey your parents. There's no period that is given. It's a lifetime thing to obey your parents. So don't think marriage, you will just take it on your own and disregard what the parents are going to say. And the input of the parents is important, because parents can be able to read character better than you. Because when you are inside this thing and you want it to work, because you now have some kind of like to say, because you guys, you're busy talking about time, God will tell you when the right time is. Remember, marriage is a gift from God. Remember, God says marriage is for matured people. And a relationship with God is for matured people. Some of us stayed, got married on the fifth year. You know? So there's no time. As long as God sees, you're still not ready. I'm here to follow the child. Because it's not something that comes from you. If you're going to want instant coffee, you're not going to have the scent that comes from brewed coffee. You enjoy the scent before you even drink the coffee. But if you want instant coffee, you drink the coffee, the scent is gone.
So it is better to take time to know and remember to consult God all the way, because even in the marriage, you will need God to be with you. You will need God to be with you. That's why even when you are married, you have time to go and pray on your own, pray for your partner and pray for yourself and pray for your marriage. So God is what we should be looking to please. Because he says, if you love me, keep my commandments. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is a light.
Should say, there is me before us, there is him before us.
And yena according to Lama standard at the Suezua begging us standards as in general to me, who Nando Nano Nando, in due time, who don't provide the actual Mutica, Logo Gaswana, and now you know what now I'm ready. Nano will be still consulting.
And remember, because you are in this thing, you'll be compromised to change some of your standards, to lower them a bit. You know, but God is still on the first level of the standards that you set together. You remember?
Mm-hmm.
When this person will say nice things, you will change to say, hey, noma ngabe aga enkonzweni uya ngema Easter's once in a year. It's fine because we are. But to God, God doesn't change his standards. His standards are just standards. And being a girl child, remember, you have a ministry, a kai, when God blesses you with children.
Mm-hmm.
Your ministry starts first. Immediately you see that you've conceived, you have to be able to preach and guide the child and make the child know that you have a relationship with God, you know. But the father will come when the child is there. And even wait sometimes until the child is a teenager. And then the father will sometimes just throw a word. But you as a mother, your ministry started before. Marriage is a ministry. Because whatever we do as married couples, it should represent God. People who don't believe in God, they should see that. Even if there are so many divorces, but God can be able to make two sinners stay together. Remember, we're both sinners. So we both need this person who's going to cleanse us and make us to be sober-minded.
Oh, maybe, Jay. The question I make to you, is could make a man a crush as the girl child? Niyayi boni crush yam wethu man cetsa bona wethu 2-3 months down the line mbaza wethu I know but crush yam mamazi ngilebali wethu akasuki how do I get to deal with that how ngiyenda njani lapho because ebe crush yam I made a move ngiyalo sengayi crush yam sengiyayiboni crush yam.